Okay, next we proceed to supply. Okay, so what is meant by supply? Supply means when you have the ability or willingness to sell. The willingness or ability to sell at a particular price. So what is meant by quantity supply? Quantity supply is represent the number of units of a product that a firm would be willing and able to offer for sale at a particular price during a given time period. Okay. Itu pada ni lah kuantiti yang kita nak jual. Okay, next. Law of supply. So, law of supply, you assume you as a seller. Tadi you baca demand. Demand, you assume you as a buyer. So, buyer, buyer, buyer confirm dia nak lower price. But for seller, kalau you as a seller, you nak jual harga barang murah ke tinggi? Of course, tinggi. So, as a seller, you want to get a higher profit, right? So you akan letakkan harga tinggi lah. Okay. So law of supply state that when price rises, quantity supply also increase lah. Okay. When price rises, quantity supply will also increase. Jadi bila harga meningkat, quantity supply also meningkat. But when price falls, quantity supply also falls. Okay. So it's just a positive relationship lah between price and quantity supply. Bila harga jatuh, kuantiti supply jatuh. Bila harga naik, kuantiti supply naik. So, how to draw supply curve sama jugalah. Okay. Macam inilah. See supply curve. You draw the vertical and horizontal line. Then you letakkan scale lah. Tak scale. And then plot lah. So, it's just a positive slope. Okay. A positive slope. So, what is the differences between individual supply and market supply? Okay, individual supply is the supply of one seller in a market at various price. Okay, tadi lah. Okay, market supply refer to one seller. Yang ni market supply refer to the all the sellers lah. Okay, selling in the market for that good or services. Okay. Contoh tadi kan, Ali seorang jual rambutan. Okay, Ali tu refer pada one seller ataupun individual supply. Then bila ada Abu Acun juga jual rambutan, so we total up semua quantity supply dia tu. Kopi supply, kopi rambutan yang dijual. So, itu adalah market supply. So, determinants of supply, there are price factor and non-price factor. So, for price factor, price itself. Okay, so how to explain price itself? When price increases, kopi supply also increase. When price decreases, kopi supply will decrease. Okay, so it shows a positive relationship between price and kopi supply. So, determinants of supply for non-price factor, ada banyak lah tadi lah. Okay. Determinants lain dia punya, sorry, demand lain dia punya determinants, supply lain dia punya determinants, okay. So, for supply, determinants of supply for non-price factor, first is cost of production, technological advancement, government policies, price of related goods, number of suppliers and expected future price. At least we ingat 4 atau 5 lah, okay. Okay, first is cost of production. Okay, cost production to apa? Cost production is cost of producing the good, which in turn depends on the piece of required inputs, labor, capital, and land. Example, when the wages of workers increases, the cost of production will increase, so supply will decrease. Itu normal lah kan? Okay, bila upah meningkat, maksudnya melibatkan cost. Cost meningkat, so supply will decrease. Okay, supply curve shift to the left. Technological advancement generally will increase the supply of product lah. Normal lah. Biasanya kita guna teknologi, supply of product akan meningkat. Technology advancement reduce the use of input and cost of production. So, more output can be produced using the same amount of input and cost lah. Okay. So, supply of good will increase by using technology if there is an advancement technology. Government policies. Taxes imposed by the government on certain good will reduce supply on the market. This incentive to producer because it increase the cost of production. Example, tax on cigarettes. Normally, when government impose tax to the producer, okay, cost of production will increase. Then, okay, bila government kenakan tax, cost of production akan meningkat. So, supply of good will decrease. Okay. Contohnya, you ni baker. Okay, you baker. You buat roti, contohnya. You buat roti. And then, contohnya ada ada SST sekarang kan. SST tu mahal. So melibatkan cost production. Kalau maksudnya cost untuk buat roti lagi mahal. So supply of roti akan berkurang lah. Okay, price ataupun okay. Kalau government, kalau subsidi pula macam mana? So kalau subsidies kan, ini poin yang sama je lah, tax and subsidy sebenarnya. Satu lagi subsidy, when government give subsidy, so cost of production will decrease, supply of good will increase. Contohnya government bagi subsidy dari segi, contohnya lah, as a baker, government bagi, you buat bisnes roti, government bagi mesin, bagi oven yang lagi besar. So, you dah tak perlu beli dah capital tu. So, you punya cost dah berkurang, so you akan supply lagi banyak. So, supply of cake ataupun bread akan meningkat. Okay, price of other goods. Okay, substitute and complements. Okay, substitute when an increase in the price of substitute good decreases the supply of the good. Okay, when the price of soybean increase, supply of soybean all produce will be increased and supply of palm oil will be decreased. Okay, so kita saya ambil tea and coffee lah senang. Tea and coffee. Bila harga tea meningkat, contohnya you ni jual kopi, you ada kedai runcit, you jual tea and coffee. Bila harga tea meningkat, you akan jual, kalau harga tea meningkat, you as a seller, you akan jual lagi banyak tea, kan tak? Bila harga tea meningkat, quantity supply of tea will increase. So, supply of coffee, you jual banyak ke sikit? You akan supply sikit saja sebab harga tea lagi mahal. So, you jual banyak lah. You akan jual banyak lah tea. Okay? So, supply of coffee will decrease, supply of tea will increase. Okay? Sambil increase ni. When the price of soybean increase. Bila harga soybean increase, harga soybean increase, the supply of soybean akan meningkat juga. So, supply untuk palm oil akan berkurang. Okay? But you as a seller, you akan jual lagi banyak barang yang harga lagi tinggi. Okay. Complement and increase in the price of goods will increase the supply of other goods. Okay, contohnya, tali and, ini shuttle cord and racket. Contohnya, car and tire. Bila harga kereta naik, quantity supply of kereta akan juga menaikkan. So, supply of tire juga akan meningkat. So, supply curve should be right. Okay. The number of suppliers. The larger the number of suppliers supplying good, the larger is the supply of the good. Namun kan, bila ramai supplier, ramai penjual, kan banyak juga the supply of goods. Okay. Example, increase in stationery shop in Perak will increase the supply of stationery good in Perak. Okay. Expected future price. If the producers expect in the near future will increase, supply for today will reduce and vice versa. Contohnya lah, contohnya producer expect that price of sugar, contohnya lah, price of sugar will increase for the next month. Next month akan meningkat ni. So supply sugar this month will decrease sebab dia nak jual lagi banyak next month. Sebab next month harga akan naik. So dia akan jual sikit je this month. Okay. So the differences between changes in quantity supply and changes in supply. So apa yang jangka faktor berlaku dalam QS, quantity supply. What is the definition? Definition dia movement along the same supply curve. Okay. So macam ni lah. Price, quantity supply. This is supply curve. Okay, katanya 0, 1, harga 1 ringgit, 2 ringgit, 3 ringgit. At 1 ringgit, quantity supply is 2. At 2 ringgit, seringgit eh. Boleh ke? Sini lah. Seringgit lagi nak pula. Nanti kita skip. Quantity supply, price. 2, 0, 1 ringgit, 2 ringgit, 3 ringgit, 4 ringgit. Okay, 2 kilo, 4 kilo, 6 kilo, 8 kilo. Okay, at 1 ringgit, quantity supply is 2. Okay, macam ni lah. Okay, this is supply curve. So at 1 ringgit kuantiti supply, contohnya at 1 ringgit kuantiti supply is 2 kilo, then bila harga naik 2 ringgit kuantiti supply is 4 kilo. So it's just a movement and an upward movement, right? Okay, because there is an increase in price. So kenapa dia bergerak, kenapa berlaku perubahan dalam kuantiti disebabkan oleh faktor harga, price itself. Okay, contohnya ini adalah price of rambutan, kuantiti supply of rambutan, harga rambutan itu sendiri. Okay, factor influence is price determinant. Okay, but change in supply, shift of supply curve. Maksudnya macam ni, this is supply curve. SO ni asal, QS, price, supply curve shift to the right, S1 or shift to the left. Apa-apa yang bertambah ke kanan, maksudnya supply meningkat. Yang bergerak ke kiri, supply makin berkurang. Shift of supply curve, apa yang menyebabkan faktor, apa yang menyebabkan supply tu gerak ke kiri ke kanan, sebab oleh faktor non-price determinants. What are the determinants? Number of sellers, technological advancement, apa lagi, cost of production yang tadi tu. Okay, non-price determinants. So, price will remain constant. Harga batu sendiri tidak mempengaruhi change in supply. Okay, so this is the factor lah. Semua. So this is the diagram lah. Dan juga, okay, kenapa berlakunya upward movement ataupun expansion? Okay, kenapa berlakunya expansion? Kan ini expansion kan? Ini upward movement. When price increase, quantity supply also increase. So it shows an upward movement or expansion movement. Okay, kenapa berlakunya contraction movement? Because of when price decrease, quantity supply also decrease. So it shows a downward movement or contraction movement. Okay, sama okay, yang ni pula changes in supply. Okay, maksudnya supply shift to the right. Ini kan, or shift to the left. Kenapa dia shift to the right? Okay, so because supply increase. Kenapa supply increase? Maybe price of substitute decrease. Ataupun price of component. Price of complement goods increase. Okay, contohnya price of substitute, saya ambil substitute tea and coffee tadi kan. Bila harga tea turun, okay, substitute dia adalah coffee. Bila harga tea turun, quantity supply of tea also turun. Betul tak? Sebab dia kan lot of supply. But supply of coffee will increase. Bila harga tea murah, seller tak akan jual dah tea. Dia akan jual lagi banyak coffee. Pengganti berita dalam coffee kan. So supply of coffee akan meningkat. So supply can shift to the right. Okay, expected future price decrease when government gives subsidy. Bila government gives subsidy, cost of production akan berkurang. So supply barang akan lagi banyak. So supply curve shift to the right. And leftward, sebaliknya lah. Supply curve shift to the left. Okay, kalau ini price of substitute decrease, yang ini pula price of substitute increase. Okay, contohnya, price of tea increase, quantity supply of tea also increase. So supply of coffee will decrease. Bila harga tea dah mahal, seller akan jual sikit dia coffee. Supply curve shift to the left lah. Okay, sebab supply of coffee will decrease. Okay, boleh. Okay, exceptional supply for labor market. Ini berlaku dalam labor market tadi ya. Pasaran buruh. Against the law of supply, where is the price increases, coffee supply decreases. Ini berlawanan dengan law of supply lah. Okay, bila harga mahal, supply akan berkurang. Okay, apa faktor dia? Income effect. A higher income induce increase in demand for leisure. So, less time spent on work and there is a decrease in the quantity of labor supply. Okay, normally kalau you lah gaji dah besar RM50,000 sebulan. You nak kerja buat OT lagi pun? Tak kan? You akan kurangkan bekerja sebab you akan demand for leisure. You akan nak spend masa untuk keluarga, untuk jalan-jalan holiday. Kan? So, bila harga tinggi, harga upah tu tinggi, so, you tak akan offer diri untuk bekerja lagi. So, supply of labor will decrease. Okay, faham? Contohnya you bekerja sebagai engineer. Gaji you dah RM3,000 sebulan. RM3,000 sebulan. You nak tambah job lain lagi ke? Tak. Sebab gaji dah tinggi. Harga upah you dah tinggi. So, you akan supply of labor tu will decrease lah. Okay, in terms of labor market. Okay? So, that's all for chapter 2. Thank you.